How do I keep my dog from playing keep away? Welcome to Cornerstone Gundog Academy, where you can learn to train your retriever with our online videos. There's nothing more frustrating than when you go for a retrieve, you send your dog, they grab it perfectly, they run out as fast as they can, they start coming back, then they look at you, and then they decide to turn the other way or start doing a big victory lap and don't want to come straight back to you. So the question is, what do you do, or how do you prevent that from happening? And actually, the key word there is prevention. And preferably, you prevent it. Now, I'm actually, towards the end of this tip here, I will actually go over some steps that you can go through to fix it, because, you know, if you're in the situation and it's already happening, you need a solution. But there's nothing more important than prevention. It's always better to prevent than to have to find a cure for something. So when it comes to the early stages, this really comes back to as soon as you bring your puppy home at about seven, eight weeks old, somewhere right in there, or really whenever you brought your puppy home. And what we like to do is do early retrieving, which actually we don't do a lot of early retrieving, because to tell you the truth, your dog, if you've got a really well-bred dog, it is innate within your dog, an innate desire to retrieve. So all you need to do is just enough retrieving to wake that desire up. But what we like to do is we like to find a hallway in the house, preferably if that's possible, a natural channel or funnel that causes the dog really has no other option but to come straight back to you. Now, the only thing that can happen is when you do try to retrieve in the hallway, if they decide not to come back to you, they could just lay down at the end of the hallway and start chewing on whatever you're retrieving. And if that happens, I would encourage you, don't sweat it. Don't worry about it. Just go get your puppy and then don't retrieve for a week or two and then come back and then try it again. The big thing is, most people over retrieve with their young puppy. So you can prevent a lot of problems by not retrieving too much and by focusing on the things that your puppy needs most, which is socialization and obedience. Now, let's say you're already down the road a little. Your puppy's a little older, they're really kind of at a point to where you can really start gun dog training with them, some more of the gun dog skills, and you're having a huge problem with that dog not coming straight back. Well, what do you do in that situation? Well, you're gonna have to find a way to stop your dog from doing that. And I'm gonna go over this in a quick flyby view, because this ultimately, if I were to give you every step here, it would be a couple of hours that we'd be sitting here talking. But here's what you can do. You need to create a situation that your dog can win in. And here's how I would recommend doing it. You need to create essentially an outdoor hallway. And so the way you can do that is you can go to your local hardware store or maybe order online in today's day and age with the craziness that's going on, and get some garden posts. And you may already have these, just some plastic garden posts. Get just enough to make a long, maybe 20-ish, 20-foot, 25-foot lane, and then get some plastic or some rubber-type chicken wire or some sort of fencing that you can zip tie onto these garden posts. And then you can create a natural lane. And now you have an outdoor lane that your dog can go get the retrieve in and then come back. The other tool you might want to use in this situation is a check cord, because if your dog goes down to the end of the lane and they decide to repeat what they did as a puppy and lay down and start chewing, you can do a light tug and then have them come on back. And it's important that you use the check cord properly and actually precondition your dog to the check cord so that you're not creating bad habits, which that's in depth in our 52 plus program as far as understanding how to do that. Once you've gone through that process, it's all about conditioning. You have to condition your dog to come straight back to you. And I'll tell you this, it's really ultimately whatever habits that you create. So when it comes down to conditioning, you just have to repeat over and over and over and essentially drill it in. You want to train to the level that your dog basically dreams about this in their sleep. And if you repeat having your dog successfully come back to you that many times, then what you can do is after the lane, you can transfer out of the man-made lane and you can go out into a natural lane, which would be like a field where you've cut a grass lane in it, and start conditioning the retrieve in that lane. Once you've done that, then you can transfer it to more of an open field and then condition it in there. And then as long as you keep repeating success over and over and over, eventually your dog's gonna forget about the running around and they're gonna think that, okay, it's time to come straight back every single time. And I'll tell you this last thing, if you do that and then all of a sudden your dog reverts back to old ways, maybe when you've introduced something new, don't sweat it, just take a small step back, repeat it, remind your dog what they're supposed to do, show them exactly what you want them to do, and then keep moving forward. So that is some ways that you can help prevent your dog from playing keep away. And again, There's an in-depth process of this in our 52 plus program. You can check that out if you decide to purchase the program. We'll show you exactly how to work through it in depth, step by step.